Siwmai, a chroeso i'r sianel YouTube am ieithoedd y byd. Mae'r fideo hwn am y Gymraeg. Dwi ddim yn siarad Cymraeg yn dda iawn. 8 mlynedd yn ôl, roeddwn i'n Cymru, dim ond un wythnos, hoffwn i ymweld â Chaerdyddau do, achos mae'n llawer o hwyl. Y tro nesaf, hoffwn i fynd i wylio gêm rygbi yn Stadiwm y Millennium, achos dwi wrth fy modd yn gwylio rygbi. Dwi'n hoffi Cymru ar hyn o bryd, a dwi'n gallu siarad Cymraeg tipyn bach, ond dwi eisiau siarad Cymraeg yn rhugl. Rwyf yn gefnogwr cryf i'r iaith Gymraeg. Pam dwi'n sgu Cymraeg? Gwyddym ffodd iaith yn ganolog i ddiwylliant. Mae gan i'r iaith Gymraeg ddiwylliant gyffoethog, ac ni bydd Cymru heb Gymraeg. Och ydych chi'n dod o Gymru, ac os ydych chi'n siarad yn o'i dysgu Gymraeg, mae groeso chi's grifin o adyf. Diolch yn fawr, ac bob ydym yn ei da. So guys and girls, that was my attempt at speaking Welsh, the Celtic language of Wales. Spoken by some 500,000 people there and in Argentina, there's a small Welsh colony in Patagonia. Welsh has a huge literary, musical, cultural tradition. It's a really old language. I picked it up when I was in Wales for a week in 2006, and I'm far from being fluent in Welsh, but it's one of the languages I most enjoy using for no specific reason. It's just beautiful. And apart from being the mother tongue of Duffy, who sang Mercy to global fame some 5 years ago, the best known Welsh word in pop culture is that's 51 letters. It's the longest place name in the British Isles. You can read it in the comment description of this video. And don't let it scare you. Welsh words aren't usually that long. Like in other Celtic languages, in Breton, in Cornish, which are pretty close to Welsh, but also in Irish Gaelic, Scottish Gaelic, and Manx, which are a bit more distant, Welsh words often undergo mutations at their beginning, meaning that the first or several of the letters at the beginning change. The Welsh word for Cardiff, the capital city of Wales, is Caerdydd, which begins with a C, whereas to go to say you're going to Cardiff, you would say I Gaerdydd, where the C changes to a G, and in Cardiff is Yng Gaerdydd, meaning that the C changes to an NGH at the beginning. That looks a bit strange if you're a beginner, but it's a very typical and actually quite easy to learn feature of all Celtic languages. Once in an interview, I said that Welsh was one of my favorite languages, and that got me a real shitstorm of comments from a lot of people who are like, oh, this guy's so stupid, he doesn't know that they speak English in Wales and Welsh is just a dialect of English. No, Welsh, as you could hear in the beginning, is very much different from English. People do speak English in Wales, but they also speak Welsh, and they have been doing so since at least the 6th century. And as I said, the language itself has a humongous tradition, and although it's spoken by only about one-fifth of the people in Wales, it's still very much alive and kicking. Even the name Welsh, in fact, comes from an old Germanic word that means foreign or not understandable. In Polish, Włoski, in Hungarian, Olaszul, is the name for the Italian language, just like in German, Welsh, used to design every single Romanic language, French or Italian, that was close to German. And if you remember my video about Romanian from last week, you remember that there are Romanian dialects spoken south of the Danube called Vlaški by people who speak Slavic languages. Now, those are all words related to the word Welsh. That's it for today. If you want to know more, if you have questions, if you speak Welsh, if you're learning Welsh, please, please, please write to me here on YouTube or on my Facebook page. I'd be happy to hear from you. Diolch o galon. Thank you from my heart. And hwyl fawr. A lot of fun. See ya.